here. So this is introduction to R. Then eventually creation of data vector, vector arithmetic, then extraction from a vector, naming a vector, a plot with different plotting characteristics, matrix operation, differentiation with R, virtually integration with R, then probability distributions in R, simulation, look into the graphics, plotting function using curve, plotting normal distribution and with T, and with T, C, sampling distribution with R, replicate, fitting a distribution using optim, fitting exponential distribution, comparing two groups, t-test, pair t-test using formula argument, creation of a list, t-test with a data frame, pair t-test, another way of creating data frame using stack, graphic features of data analysis, analysis of variance, regression analysis, fit a simple regression model, fit a polynomial regression model, define a new function, creation of data frame from Excel, nonlinear models, check chicks growth data, fit exponential growth model for a data, look into the graphics, the family of apply functions, L apply, S apply, and T apply, statistical analysis of categorical data, use the function xtabs for the same purpose, use chi-square test for testing association of sugar with age, odds ratio analysis, then define a new function for odds ratio, Fisher's exact test for the same, look into the graphics of this data, analysis of logic models, fitting of the model, get analysis of deviance, look into the graphics, survival analysis with R, non-parametric survival, Kaplan-Meier, and virtually the comparison of two curves. See, so this is my HTML file, but before coming on these things, I would like to give introduction about the R markdown. Just, I'm closing here. Virtually, you have to open. Just a minute. The first thing is that you have to open a folder, and then in that folder, actually, you put all the basic source file. So virtually, I would like to come there. Just suppose you have created a new folder here. How to begin with? So this is a new folder. Say, name it Shanti. And then what you will do, you will go into R Studio. You have to install R as well as R Studio. Both are open source software packages. Both need to be installed, R and R Studio. And then R Markdown and Knit R. See, I'm just opening. First, you have to open the folder, a new folder, and then go to R Studio. Yes. See, I'm just opening a go to new, and then there are many options. We will go into R Markdown. You know, there are many options like R Notebook, R Script, then Shiny Web Application, then virtually the Plumber, C file, C++, header file, Markdown file, HTML file, JavaScript, many things are there, Python script, then shell script, SQL, stand file. There are many R sweep, there are many options, but I'm going to R Markdown. And see here, the default option here, the first option is documentation, second is presentation, third is Shiny applications, and then the fourth one is from template. So here it is title. Make some title, say for example, data analysis. And then there are many options, HTML output, PDF, Word, but I have given the default HTML output. Understand? Now you will save this. You will save this into the folder which you have created. Save as. Go to the desktop. It is Shanti. Name the file. Say the file name is Shanti. Understand? There's no problem. See. Now you close from here and close from here and go to the folder Shanti. See. Now this RMD file, R markdown file has been created. Open it again. See, here, this one is the source file. And actually, this is the console, R console. And this one is the, actually, this window is for the files, which we like, we have created shanti.rmd. Here, this part, three dash and three dash, in that, we are writing title, data analysis, author AAK, date 2811, output document HTML. Here we can change the document, like we can write Word, so it will convert Word. If you write PDF document, you will find PDF. And virtually, there is a knit button. So from here, you can run knit to HTML, knit to PDF, knit to Word, and virtually, there are many other things too. So here, we will just click on knit to HTML. See, we have got the HTML file. See, this is the output after running this. Just I would like to show you that how this source file has been created. By default, you will get in R markdown, this part, three dashes in between. This is the virtually the front part of the document in which we are writing title, author, date, and some other options are there. There is a book by Zai Wai. And the other book is actually by Christopher Gundrud. Tomorrow I will tell you the complete reference of these books. Christopher Gundrud has written a book, Reproducible Research with R and R Markdown, like that. So here actually the main feature of this R Markdown is that virtually it combines narratives as well as code together. So you can do data analysis by using some statistical software, and you can do documentation also. Like, you know, here we can just, these are the R commands. Say for example, an R command, this whole is known as chunk. So it begins with triple backticks, then inside the curly bracket, you write R setup, include is equal to false. Knit R. So these are the options. Even we can drop these options. Yes. See, single hash means main heading. Here we are using double hash, that means subheading. Subheading. So and now we are writing. This is an R mark document. We are writing narratives. Markdown is a simple formatting syntax for authoring HTML, PDF, and MS Word documents. For more detail, use R Markdown, see HTTP, this is the website. When you click the knit button here, you know, they are writing knit in double star. If you write in double star, it will be typed into bold. If you write in single star, it will be typed in italic. So here, knit button document will be generated that includes both content as well as output of any embedded R code chunk. Understand? You can embed an R code chunk here. Like, you know, this is the R code chunk. Triple backticks. Backticks goes into the top left corner, and it is below tilde. So here R, That means if you write here Python, that means you are having interaction with Python. There are many other options. So R cars is the level of this, and then summary cars is the data. So if you want to write, say, for example, this, just click here, control enter, control plus enter. See, we got the summary. See, we run it. We write the commands here, control plus enter. We can directly write here, but here, actually, if you write here, say, for example, you are getting the summary of results. Summary of results here, that is the variables. Even we can get, suppose, control one in source window and control two to this window. If you want to know about the data cars, you can have, say, for example, the function in R is head, header part of the data. See, this is the header part. मैं कहता हूं कि जब आपको कोई डेटा देखना हो तो सबसे पहले हम क्या कहते हैं, नाम पूछो, नेम्स, नेम्स कार, कार्स, इट विल शो यू द नेम ऑफ द नेम ऑफ द डेटा ऑब्जेक्ट, इट इज अ रेक्टेंगुलर डेटा. देन सी, फिर आप चेहरे का दीदार कर लो, एंड दैट इज हेड. और उसके बाद पैरों का दीदार करना है तो क्या हो जाएगा हेड के बदले, टेल, टी ए आई एल, टेल, टेल, हेड एंड टेल, टेल. सी, फ्रॉम बॉटम इट शोज द डेटा, अंडरस्टैंड. एंड इफ यू वांट टू नो समथिंग मोर अबाउट द होल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द डेटा, एस टी आर, एंड देन यू राइट कार्स, द नेम ऑफ द डेटा ऑब्जेक्ट. It is a data frame with 50 observations and two variables. The first variable is speed, it is numeric. Second variable is distance, it is also numeric. So virtually you can do data analysis with this data. Now seconds, you come into control one, come into this window. The another subsection we have created, double hash marks means subsection, and single means main section, and triple hash marks means subsection. So we are going to introduce another subsection, and that is include plots. You can close this by just clicking here, another subsection, and that is include plots. You can also type embed plots, for example. So this is the narrative part, this is the documentation, and then we are using the R chunk again, triple back ticks, end with triple back ticks, and here inside the curly bracket you write R, and with the space you can label that. Say for example, here we are labeling it as pressure, echo is equal to false is not required. Then plot pressure. Just first I would like to go into, if you will run it, you just click here, you can run it the whole, or you can just click here, use control plus enter, you are getting the plot. Suppose control 2, we have reached here, the data is pressure. Again you can have names pressure. See, this seems to be data frame. Then head, this is a data frame, like, understand. Then tail part you can have. I'm just writing a structure of the data, and that is pressure. See, this is a data frame with 19 observations and two variables. Suppose you want to know more details about this, the function is help. Actually R is a functional language. And for everything we have a function. Say for example, yes, for example, are you able to hear me? Awaaz aa rahi hai? Hello.
Yes sir.
Awaaz aa rahi hai na?
Yes
sir. Is share ho rahi hai? Ji.
You are audible.
Suppose we want to know pressure.
Yes sir.
Right, pressure. So here,
Sir.
Yes.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes, 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 of course.
Sir, what about the data you are working right now? Is it show? Is it already stored in the HTML that you have shown us earlier?
No, no. Virtually, this data, there is a package data sets in R. When you download R, there is a package data sets in R in the base R. So these data sets are there. See, I'm just showing about the data. See, like the data pressure, it is showing where it is. Pressure, it is in data set package. Anna, vapor pressure of mercury as a function of temperature. Your answer is here. Description of the data. Data on the relation between temperature in degrees Celsius and vapor pressure of mercury in millimeters of mercury. Usage. You just type pressure, you will find the data. You just type pressure here, you will see the data. Format, it is a data frame.
Yes, see,
the detail is here. Just type help pressure and you will get the data. Understand?
Okay, thank you.
A data frame with 19 observations. Source, Wiest RC et al. 1973 Handbook of Chemistry and Physics, CRC Press. Then the same Mac Neil DR 1997 Interactive Data Analysis. And these are certain examples on this data set. So that we will talk later. So this is the all. All the things are documented very well. If you have your own data, you have to enter your data. That I will talk, that how to enter the data. Understand? Say, I will come on those things. So here, this chunk is complete. Note that now they have made a comment.
Could I ask another question? Like, why, like, is this data set given for learning purposes? Like, for example, as a resource to R?
It is a resource to R. It is a resource to R, actually.
So, sir,
actually, there is a big package, and there are many other data sets, you know, thousands of data sets are available with R. Say, for example, if you made your own software, and if you want to put on CRAN, you want to join with R community, you have to make your data available with that package. Like, you know, on cluster analysis, there is a package cluster in R. So they have provided data of all those cluster analyses. That is an implementation, mainly an implementation of a book on cluster analysis, that how to find groups, published by John Wiley. Similarly, for actually mixed effect models, there is a package NLME. There is a book, Modern Applied Statistics with S Plus, mass book. So this is a book written by Venables and Ripley, and virtually they have provided, they have discussed many data sets in their book. They have given some other concepts too. That is a great book on data analysis using S plus and R. So they have provided a package MAS, and which gives all the data sets and all the functions which are discussed inside the book. So this is the concept of packages in R. Understand?
Sir,
even if you write a paper, yes.
I had a
query.
Like you said na, we have downloaded. हाँ सर, हमने अभी वो लिंक जो भेजे थे उन्होंने जया जी ने तो हमने वो डाउनलोड किया है अभी आर और आर स्टूडियो. तो आपके हिसाब से मतलब आप बता रहे हो कि उसमें ऑलरेडी कुछ डेटा ऑलरेडी इनबिल्ट हम लोग को उधर डाल दिया जाता है, राइट?
आर में ये सब डेटा सेट आर में ही मौजूद हैं. हाँ, ये सब मौजूद हैं. इसी वजह से अभी हम नहीं आ रहे कि कैसे डेटा एंटर करेंगे. अभी हम आएंगे. अभी अभी तो ये हमारा, ये तो जस्ट डिस्प्ले है. अभी हम मेन अपने टॉक पर आएंगे, जो हमारा चांस की टॉक.
So one last question, would you give these resources through email to us, sir? Would you be able to share these resources, like the books, soft copy of books and papers?
Yes, sir. What about the naming of books?
Actually, books I will talk. I will talk about the books also. Understand? There are many books, very good books. And virtually, I will share my document to you all. I will send a copy of the PDF copy of the document. Understand? And I will try to send a source, this source file also, the source file of my document, so that you can learn from there. So
thank you, sir.
Just hear patiently, then after hearing something, Anna, you shall be able to get answer of many questions, and then we can discuss later on. Let me first give the concept, understand. Note that here we have made, and this is the end of this whole thing. Now to generate, there are two ways to generate the HTML document. See, what we are doing, just click on Knit to HTML. See here, data analysis, title, date are marked down. This is the main subsection. Then another subsection. Here we are having the commands, its outputs, and our narratives, everything in a documented form. Understand? In a documented form. So this is our HTML file. And then if you want PDF, you just click on knit button, knit to PDF. See, it is converting into PDF. Yeah. So this is the PDF. This is the PDF. Actually, for getting PDF, you have to install actually the book, which I will talk tomorrow, that gives the details. There are many book on R Markdown. So virtually here you can get all those files. Click. See, this is the PDF, this is the HTML file, and this is our RND, this is our source file. Say, if you want to look into HTML file, just. So this is the HTML file, understand? Now I'm just closing it, and if you want to look into the PDF, this has been generated because of our Knit to PDF. So this is the PDF file. For getting PDF, actually you have to install a package, actually. This PDF gets converted because of LaTeX, and actually the small LaTeX you can install by a package of R, that is TinyTeX. Tomorrow I will talk about, you know, and I will tell you that books also, some books which are very important for learning these things. So this is the PDF. To get Word, what you have to do? Knit to Word. Knit to Word. From the same source document, we are getting all these things. It will convert into Word. See. Actually, I have. So this is the Word document. This is the Word document which you can open into the Word. I have, actually, this is not licensed Word. I have this installed. Actually, I never support any license software. Rather, I always popularize those which are easily, which are open source, like LibreOffice. So I'm opening it with LibreOffice. See, this is the Word. The same document you can get output into the Word also. But I recommend that you should get HTML as well as the PDF. And for getting PDF, you have to install a package, TinyTeX, then underscore, then install underscore and TinyTeX, and put the round bracket that will install a small LaTeX software. And actually, that is very useful. So actually, instead of going to knit button from here also, what you can do, you have to install R Markdown. You know, around 25 packages, you know, at present, there are more than 12,000 packages in R. But out of those, only 25 packages are part of the base. When you download R, there are only 25 packages which are part of base document. And, you know, among them, one package is very popular among the data analysts, that is for graphics, aur wo machli baat khane wala usne develop kiya hai. Machli baat khane wala kaun hai? Boliye, machli baat khane wala kaun hai? Hello,
all are Bengalis.
He is Dipayan Sarkar. Actually, you know, R was developed by Ross Ihaka and Robert Gentleman at the University of Auckland. And virtually Dipayan Sarkar was the PhD student of Robert Gentleman. So he has developed a package, and that is known as Lattice package. That is very popular. And there are three graphics, base graphics, which are developed by Robert Gentleman. Then the graphics which I am showing, that is base graphics. Then second was developed by his student Dipayan Sarkar, and it is known as Lattice package, and it is among the recommended packages. And virtually the third, the latest fashion is ggplot2. It is ggplot2 grammar of graphics, ggplot2, which is developed by Helly Wickham. He is a man in RStudio, and he is a big man. He is a big contributor in the field of data science. So that is ggplot2. Tomorrow I shall talk about, I may talk about these things. Okay. So here you just require, actually you need to install. You need to install, and the command is install.packages. See the command, install.packages. And here you name the software, and that is R Markdown. Understand? The name of the package is R Markdown. And you just press enter, it will install. It will be installed. Once it is installed, there is no need of installing it again and again. Just you require our library. So similarly, to install TinyTEX, you just try to install that packages TinyTEX. So I'm not going to install because it is already installed. Another way is here, going to the tools, install packages, click on install packages, and here a window is coming. Here you can write R Markdown and just click on install, it will be installed. So these are the many ways how to install a package which is not installed, like here. So just you use library or require library R Markdown. Press enter. Now there is a function. Instead of going to the net button, we can give command from here, and that is render, name the file. The file is, the name of the file is what? It is shanti.rmd, SHA, shanti.rmd. If you will just press enter, it will generate the HTML file, but here I'm going to HTML underscore, this is the output, underscore document, HTML document. Here TOC is equal to true, that is the table of contents, and TOC underscore depth is equal to 2. So it will go up to section and subsection, and you just press enter. TOC, देखिए यहाँ दो बार double हमारा दब गया है, ठीक है. It is generating. It has generated the HTML file, which you can find from here. This is just generated. ठीक. Now I will go again to the same, use cursor key of the keyboard and click here. Suppose you want to generate the PDF, you write here, instead of HTML, write PDF. PDF generates many things, understand? So this is the file which has been generated, shanti.pdf, understand? And table of contents, everything is there. PDF is a very powerful, actually, documentation language. If you want to get the word, what you will do? Just instead of this PDF, write word. WORD, word. It has generated the word file. And you just click on .dox file and you will get it. Yes. So this is the Word file which is being opened into LibreOffice. So virtually, I think you have understood what are the basic elements of R Markdown.
Yes, now, sir.
I'm going to close it now. See, in the folder which you have created, Shanti, all these things are there. Shanti, this is the Word file, this is the HTML file, this is the PDF, and this is the source file with R Markdown file, RMD file. Microsoft Edge is the, actually this is the HTML file, and then Adobe Acrobat, this is the PDF file. So from this source file, we have generated all these things. Understand? Now I'm going to close it, and I will try to go to the document which we were having. See, here I have created a folder, and that is Shantiniketan 2820. And this folder has many files. All those things which are being generated, actually, they are being collected into this folder. So our V Bharati is the RMD file, our source file. I'm just opening that V Bharati. See, just to see what is the path, use getwd, get working directory, and press enter. It is in the G lectures Shantiniketan, and to set the directory, the function is setwd. So, and actually there are four windows. This is the source window, this is the console window, and actually there is a history window also, which is hidden, and this is the file window virtually. So we are having V Bharati. This is the title, data analysis with R, Arthur Ali Khan, I have written. Then this is the YAMLR front part. Now, one hash, that means what? Single hash means it is the main heading, introduction to R. R is a language and environment for statistical computing and graphics. Creation of a data vector, this is the subheading. Now we begin with backticks, three backticks. Then inside the curly bracket, we are writing R. And here, if it is inside the chunk, this hash mark stands for comments like any other programming language. So this stands for comments. Anything written after this will not be executed. Creation of a data vector, which are scores of 6 BTEC students. Here, we are going to talk about creation of a data vector. So it is a functional language. Actually, the data vector is, for creation of a data vector, the function is small c. You know, function, just I'm writing here. Just I'm writing the comment. You know what is function? Fx. If you write y is equal to fx, then how you will interpret it? F is the name of the function. Name of the function is always followed by a pair of parentheses, and this x is the argument of the function, and this whole is the value of the function which is assigned to an object y. Understand? See, if you have, I'm just writing a comment, say y is equal to f x1 comma x2. See what we are doing here. F, actually, y is a function of x1 and x2. Y is a function of x1 and x2. And see, the name of the function is small f. It is immediately followed by the pair of parentheses. And these are the arguments x1 separated by a comma, and that is x2. So comma operator jo hai, ye bahut important hai. Ye kya operator hai ye? Kya kaam hai iska? Huh? कामा ऑपरेटर जो है ये क्या काम कर रहा है ये? सुनना है बेटा आप लोग हमें? आर यू एबल टू हियर मी? हेलो हेलो,
यस सर,
हाँ तो बताइए जरा, कामा ऑपरेटर जो है वो क्या काम है इसका?
सेपरेट्स टू आर्गुमेंट्स,
हाँ इसको हम कहते हैं जुदाई का ऑपरेटर है ये। ये किस चीज का ऑपरेटर है? ये जुदाई का ऑपरेटर है, जुदा कर देता है एक्स वन और एक्स टू, समझ रहे हैं आप, है ना, ये जुदाई का ऑपरेटर है। ठीक है, आई एम कमिंग हियर इन दिस विंडो, दिस इज द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ ए फंक्शन, कंट्रोल वन, कंट्रोल टू टू गो टू द, कंट्रोल वन टू गो टू द सोर्स विंडो एंड कंट्रोल टू, कंट्रोल वन वी आर हियर, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू जम्प टू द कंसोल विंडो कंट्रोल प्लस टू यू रीच हियर, अंडरस्टैंड, सो कंट्रोल वन टू रीच हियर। We want to create a data vector. The function is small c for creation of a data vector. Small c. This is the name of the function, and these are the pair of parentheses, and these are the scores of the students: 2 separated by 4 separated by 3, 5, 7, 9. So these are the scores of the students. So you just type these things using the keyboard and control plus enter. You can run the single line. To print, just type the name. You will print the data. Understand? To get length, now the number of elements in the data vector x, the length function is length, so we are getting length. What is the length? There are six observations, because if number of observations are much more than, you cannot count them, and virtually you can use the function length. Then to get sum of the observations in x, what is the function? Sum. To get mean, what is the function? Mean of x. To get minimum, the function is min of x. To get maximum, max of x. To get range, the function is range. It provides minimum as well as maximum. This is the real definition of range. To get median, the function is median. To get quantiles, the function is quantile of x. The minimum is 0, the maximum is 100th percentile. The first quartile is 3.25, median is 50th percentile 4.5, and the third quartile is 6.50, and maximum is 9. To get summary of the data, the function summary, it gives brief summary of the data, you know? That is summary, minimum, first quartile, median, mean, third quartile, and maximum. To sort the data into increasing order, the function is sort. Reverse this to the decreasing order, the function is rev and then sort. See, suppose your data is here x, order as index 1 3 2 5, the minimum is 1, then the third observation, then the second observation, like that. So order is important, order as index, then same as sort x and then order. So these are the some very basic functions. Now vector arithmetic, vector, this is another main section, vector arithmetic. Since this is a command which is for narratives, from here we want to use R command, so you have to put three back ticks, then curly bracket R, and then it ends with the backtick. Here it ends with the backtick. Inside that, again we are defining a vector x. You print log of x. Log of x. By default, it is Neperian base. Log with base e. If you want to have log with base 10, you write log x. Base is equal to 10. So log with base 10. Log with base 2, you can have any base. You can have any base. This is the flexibility of the language. You can have, say, for example, someone wants log with base 3. So control 2, I'm reaching here, log of x and base is equal to 3. He wants log with base 3. This is the output. So you can have any base. Control 1 to reach this window. Here, We are talking about the recycling rule of the language. You know, one is single, it is a vector, it is a scalar, and x is a vector. So what happens, the recycling rule says a smaller vector will recycle up to the length of one, up to the length of the longer vector. So one is single, and the length of x is what? The length of x is control 2, length of x. Length of x is 6. So how one will be added to x? Understand, it will recycle 1, 1, 1 how many times? 6 times, and then plus x, the vector x, and they will be added. So what you are expecting to get? Just first I would like to type x, see, and then control 1, and just running 1 plus x. Understand, see here, 1 plus 2 3, 1 plus 4 5, 1 plus 3 4, 1 plus 5 6, 1 plus 7 8, and 9 plus 1 10. Understand? Similarly, if you want to multiply this vector with 2, so it will recycle 2 6 times, and then it will multiply with each element. So this 2 into x, and then log 1 plus x, then logarithm of 2 into x, square root of square root, then x raised power, you can have any power, like, you know, sum of x, then x raised power, just a minute, someone is telephoning me, just a minute, beta.
Hello.
Hello. See, if you want to have, actually there are 5 basic operators in arithmetic. You know, those are plus for addition, minus for negation, and then star for multiplication, and then this one is for exponentiation. So these basic 5 operators of arithmetic we have. Besides them, we have many other functions to compute, like, you know, log and other things. These are the basic arithmetic operators. So control 1, x raised power 0.32. So it will work on the whole vector. There is no need of looping, etc. For each element, it will return raised power 0.32. And then sum of that, understand? Sum of x raised power 0.32. So you can have, like here, x raised power 0.2, then sum of that. Sine of x, sine values, cos values, tan values, gamma function, then log gamma also. You can have. So these were the basic arithmetics. Now, extraction operator, this is another section. Extraction from a vector, you know, the operator is square brackets, you know, round brackets are used with the function, but square brackets are used for extraction. See, another, now we are going to write a chunk with 3 backticks, or here a comment. This is termed as extraction operator. X is equal to this. Then you print x. See, x, and then just immediately we are writing extraction operator, and we are writing 2. That means what? Extract second element. Second element is what? It is 4. Just you are getting the result 4. Extract second and fourth element. So we can combine them using C. We are extracting second element and fourth element. See, it is 4 and 5. You can read from here, second and fourth. Second is 4 and fourth is 5. So we are selecting them. Deselect second element and report remaining. No? It has deselected second element. Deselect first and third element and report remaining. So the output is this. Understand? So this is the extraction operator. we shall talk about naming a vector virtually. If you type this, this is a vector, this is without names. To name the function is names x is equal to, then again small c function is being used, but here its arguments are character strings. Monica, the score 2 is that of Monica. Then Abid, score 4 is that of Abid. Then 3 is the score of Rohit, Dhoni, Neha, Nancy. See, if you use this function, see what happens. Just type c. Dekha aapne, pehle nahi aa raha tha naam ke saath, ab naam ke saath aa raha hai ye, hai na, naam ke saath aa gaya. Aur jab naam ke saath aata hai to graphics mein hame badi aasani hoti hai. For getting graphics, the simplest graph is bar plot of x, which has these names. Less is for orientation. Main is equal to the main title of the graph, that is scores of students. I'm running this. See, this is the plot. Because of last two command here, we are getting this orientation perpendicular to this axis actually. And this is because of the argument, and that is main title score of students, which is being printed here. Understand? See, now second bar plot of x again, less good too, but color is red. Kal dekhiye, hai na, aap dekh rahe hain ki kitna chhota software hai lekin kitna smart hai, hai na. Bhalo software,
khub bhalo,
yes sir, khub bhalo.
And there is any bhalo, then khub bhalo. It is not only bhalo, it is khub bhalo, it is khub bhalo. Understand? Haan. See, we have used the kal argument, and that is kal is equal to red. Understand? There are many color options actually available with R. Control 2. Just type colors or color both. Just print. See how many color options are there? 657 color options. And virtually, Madam Shahnaz Hussain ko bhi nahi pata honge. Agar unke parlor mein koi jaye aur kahe ki sahab hame jo hai, hame chahiye wheat flour. She might not be able to understand that what kind of color she is telling. So all these color options are available with R. And virtually, because of these color options, when Dipayan Sarkar developed his lattice package, and people found that they can have many color options in their graphics, they got attracted towards R. So let the contribution of the lattice package is one which attracted the scientists towards this software. So it is, dekha aapne ye bada kitna space chahiye isko zara bataiye aap log, R ke liye kitna space chahiye, R ke installation ke liye, just 72 to 75 MB. माफ कीजिएगा, हम SPSS के लिए सौतन का वर्ड यूज करते हैं. क्या यूज करते हैं हम? सौतन का. हाँ, तो अब बताइए सौतन को कितनी जगह चाहिए इंस्टॉलेशन के लिए? GBs में ये कितने हैं खाली? 70 MB में, 100 MB से भी कम है ये, है ना. तो ये बहुत छोटा है, बड़ा स्मार्ट है, लेकिन आपने देखा कि ये बहुत रंगीन भी है. ये बहुत रंगीन भी है, देखा आपने कितने कलर ऑप्शन है इसके पास. तो ये इसकी खूबी है, है ना, कलर रेड. नाउ व्हाट वी आर डू, वी आर सॉर्टिंग द डेटा एंड वी वांट द डेंसिटी इज इक्वल टू 4. इन ईच इंच देयर शुड बी 40 लाइंस, डैश लाइंस, एंड कलर इज इक्वल टू 1 to 6. कलर नंबर हमारा 1 to 6 कलर, 6 है इसमें बार्स, तो 6 कलर में इसको कलर कर दो. दिस इज अनदर ऑप्शन. कंट्रोल इंटर, देखा आपने. हाँ, ये जो आप देख रहे हैं जो ये लाइनें हैं ये बिकॉज ऑफ डेंसिटी इज इक्वल टू 40 एंड कलर 1 to 6 फर्स्ट कलर ब्लैक देन सेकंड कलर थर्ड कलर फोर्थ कलर फिफ्थ कलर एंड सिक्स्थ कलर ठीक देन हियर यू ऑर्डर दीज बार्स बाई नेम्स है ना जब हम पूछते हैं भाई किसने टॉप किया तो उसका नाम जानना चाहते हैं उसका रोल नंबर जानना चाहते हैं तो वी आर ऑर्डरिंग दिस ग्राफ एज पर द इसको लाइक नैंसी इज गेटिंग मैक्सिमम मार्क्स अंडरस्टैंड सो ऑर्डर एज पर द नेम्स नहीं ऑर्डर एज पर द अल्फाबेटिक नेम ये देखिए नहीं अभी देखिए ये देखिए अल्फाबेटिक वी वांट ऑर्डरिंग बाय नेम्स आबिद इज द फर्स्ट धोनी मोनिका नैंसी दिस इज अल्फाबेटिक ऑर्डर बिकॉज नेम्स आर बीइंग ऑर्डर एज पर अल्फाबेट अंडरस्टैंड सो हियर डॉट चार्ट इज अनदर फंक्शन फॉर गेटिंग गुड ग्राफिक्स डॉट चार्ट नॉट बार प्लॉट नाउ डॉट चार्ट and plotting character
sir yeah. I have a question sir
yeah
yeah if we try to incorporate error bars into this
that I will talk in my
okay okay sir Understand? Okay sir
that I will talk error bars here you are from botany
I am from biotechnology
yeah biologists they often prefer that bar plot
yes sir
my tomorrow's talk will cover all those things how to add a bar plot and other things understand that is my actually Pondicherry talk and then I have modified that so here dot chart plotting character is 6 actually plotting character just I will talk dot chart this is the 16th plotting character I will show you a plot in which just like you know just I'm going to have a plot 1:20 on x-axis then 1:20 on y-axis and then color is equal to 1:20 and then cex character expansion is equal to say 1.5 so normal is 1 cex stands for c and pch plotting character is equal to 1:20 see here this is the data on x axis 1:20 on y axis also 1:20 and color is 1:20 these number like in this is the 657th color this is 656th color so here color first 20 colors then character expansion 1.5 times of the normal and plotting character like star plus circle open circle so those plotting characters when I will run this you will have a plot like this you know this is first one this is the first plotting character this is the first color and it is 1.5 times larger than the normal this is the second plotting character this is the third plotting character this is the fourth fifth like this understand so virtually this is the 16th plotting character which we are reporting here understand so this is the concept of plotting character as well as character expansion and colors in a single graph now I am coming to this window
so what is what is the use of plotting characters like
just to differentiate different lines different points understand suppose you have two lines then one line will be represented by one plotting character other line will be represented by another plotting character like that understand
and what does that cx mean sir
CEX stands for character expansion. The normal size is 1 and we want to expand it 1.5 times. So, you know, these are in bigger shape.
Okay.
To expand the size. Yeah.
So is it also possible to draw bubble diagram by, you know, like from
bubble diagram, I can't say, it might be. Bubble diagram in which you get bubbles.
Yes, bubbles. So for example, for example, if I'm showing the urban population of various cities of India, so it can show the size of a bubble and timeline.
That option is there in R. But in which package it is that we have to search. It is just read a book on any any book on R, like the most common one is Introductory Statistics with R, and that is by Delgard, and there are many other books too. Thousands of books are available with using R, so those books which are from biological sciences, they have more graphics. So there are books on ecology with R, ecological statistics with R, like that. So there is a book by Zurb,
which covers... So what was the name of the author you said? Introductory Statistics with R? Delgard.
Just you remember the name of the author. Introductory... Title of the book. And that is Introductory Statistics with R. But there is a book by Zurb, which is better for biologists. They have collected many things, data set from biological experiment, from bioenergy, etc. So that is a better book. You just write me an email, I will tell about the book. Understand? Write me an email, I will tell about that book. So that is a
okay,
better
sir, book. Thank you. Okay, sir, thank you.
Do you know how to download a book? Do you know Library Genesis?
Yes. Yes, sir.
From Library Genesis, gen.lib.rus.ec. And you just give the title of the book there and you can download that. Understand? So that is the best source. The best way to learn anything is to learn from the books first. Books are the best sources of learning. I always tell to the people that there are three main elements of learning. The one is right kind of teacher. Second is right kind of book. And the third is right kind of environment. So getting right kind of teacher is not in the hand of the learner. Getting right kind of environment is also not in the hand of learner. Otherwise, all the great people, they are taught by the great teachers. So a great teacher can produce hundreds of researchers. Anna?
Yes, understand? Sir.
A researcher may or may not. So virtually, but there are, hum kehte hain ki, there are good books and there are bad books. Anna? Kehte hain hum ki kuch पाकीजा किताबें भी हैं और कुछ नापाक किताबें हैं, है ना? तो डू यू नो झोला छाप डॉक्टर एंड लर्नेड डॉक्टर? व्हेन यू गो टू झोला छाप, व्हेन यू गो टू झोला छाप, ही आस्क व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम, देन ही राइट्स द मेडिसिन, ही आस्क फर्दर एंड देन ही राइट्स अनदर मेडिसिन, ही राइट्स अनदर मेडिसिन, अंडरस्टैंड? किसी का मोबाइल ऑन हो गया है, मोबाइल बंद कर लीजिए प्लीज। तो he writes another medicine and a volume of medicine he writes, है ना? Because he is confused that what is the relevant medicine, he does not know what is the physiology and what is the biochemistry, so he writes many medicine इस उम्मीद के साथ कि पहली वाली हो सकता काम कर जाए, नहीं पहली करेगी दूसरी कर जाएगी। तो झोला छाप डॉक्टर और पढ़े लिखे डॉक्टर में ये फर्क है। इसी तरह से झोला छाप जो किताबें हैं, वो किताबें हैं, उनकी असली पहचान क्या है कि वो बहुत मोटी होती हैं, बहुत वॉल्यूमस होती हैं, और जो टॉप बुक्स हैं ज्यादातर वो पतली होती हैं, स्मार्ट होती हैं, थिन होती हैं, ये जान लीजिए, है ना? तो एक्चुअली there is a book written by Harry Maddox. The title of the book is How to Study. How to Study. It is a publication of Penguin. That is a great book. How to choose a book and how to study a material and how to get preparations. Now that is a great book. I have put a photocopy of that book in our own seminar library, because that book is published by Penjun and that is a very costly book. And it is difficult to download it from any source. But that is a great book. You must go through that book. That is How to Study, written by Harry Maddox. So Harry Maddox makes many comments, like he tells about what should be the volume of the book, and then how you will identify that which book is good and which book is bad. So hamesha hamein paakiza kitabe prefer karna chahiye, wo kitabe jo bahut voluminous hain, jo hamare dimag ko confuse kar deti hain, un kitabon se hamein bachne ki koshish karna chahiye. Hamein sirf achhi kitabe padhna chahiye, sirf achhi kitabe. Now see, here I am coming on the window again. Dot chart, we are sorting data, and with the character, and that is plotting character is 16. See, कहाँ चला गया इसका वो graph, इसका नजर नहीं आ रहा है यहाँ पे, है ना? क्योंकि जब कभी ज्यादा बड़ा हो जाता है तो जरा मुश्किल हो जाता है उसको देख पाना, है ना? देखिए ये dot chart जो है हमारा, हमने इसको रन किया था ना, कंट्रोल ये देखिए ये आ गया, है ना? ये क्या है? The minimum marks is that of Monica because of this sort command, sort x, and plotting character is this, plotting character is 16. So the minimum marks is that of Monica, followed by Rohit, followed by Abid, followed by Dhoni, followed by Neha, and Nancy has the highest marks. Understand? So from this graphics, the same data vector, but we are running dot chart and the plotting character is 16. We get the information. You know, John Chambers says that there is no statistical tool. John Chambers, have you heard the name John Chambers? John Chambers is the man who developed actually S language, and R is written in the dialect of S language. S language was developed by John Chambers and his team, you know, which is the place from which most of the languages are developed. Do you know that institute? जहां से सी हुई, सी प्लस प्लस, जावा, यूनिक्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, ये सारी चीजें कहां से डेवलप हुई हैं? फ्रॉम बेल लैब्स यूएसए. सो वर्चुअली बेल लैब्स यूएसए, एक्चुअली फ्रॉम द नाउ डेज इट इज लूसेंट टेक्नोलॉजीज. सो फ्रॉम द बेल लैब, एक्चुअली द पीपल जॉन चेंबर्स एंड हिज टीम, दे थॉट इन 80s that they should develop a language which will suit to the direct classroom teaching, and they develop S language. Understand? They develop this S
language. Is it basic language?
चलिए, control dot chart. So John Chambers says that there is no statistical tool which is as powerful as a well chosen graph. Graphics को हम बहुत तरीके से, you know what Einstein says about the graphics? Einstein says, if I cannot picture it, I cannot understand it. If I cannot picture it, I cannot understand it. है ना? हम इसका एक भारतीय रूप भी हम बयान करते हैं ग्राफिक्स का, है ना? देखिए, जब हिंदुस्तान में शादियों के प्रपोजल चलते हैं तो शुरुआत कैसे होती है? लड़की वाला जो है वो अपनी लड़की का बायोडाटा देता है, खूब तारीफें करता है कि मेरी लड़की का ये कलर है, ये उसकी हाइट है, ये उसकी क्वालिफिकेशन है, है ना? अरे साहब, वो तो बायोटेक में उसने कम्पीट कर लिया है, शी इज वेरी इंटेलिजेंट. और लड़के वाले भी कहते हैं, अरे साहब, मेरा बेटा तो बहुत बड़ा सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर है, वो यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ जो है पिट्सबर्ग में है, या हमारा वो ड्यूक यूनिवर्सिटी में है, और ये उसकी एबिलिटीज हैं. सब कुछ होने के बाद दोनों तरफ से बायोडाटा का इंटरेक्शन हो जाता है, इवन फोटोग्राफ भी आपस में इंटरेक्ट हो जाते हैं, लेकिन तब भी ये फैसला नहीं हो पाता कि ये शादी किया जाए कि नहीं. शादी करने के लिए क्या कहा जाता है? फाइनल डिसीजन कब होगा? लड़की वाले कहते हैं कि साहब, हम लड़का एक बार देख लें, और लड़के वाले भी कहते हैं कि हम एक बार जरा लड़की देख लें, फिर हमें समझ में आ जाएगा देखने के बाद में कि ये बहू बनाने लायक है कि नहीं, या ये लड़का जो है दामाद बनाने लायक है कि नहीं, है ना। उसके लिए हम टर्म यूज करते हैं फाइनल दीदार। क्या टर्म हम यूज करते हैं? फाइनल दीदार। तो वो फाइनल दीदार जो है उसको उससे समझ में आ जाता है कि साहब ये रिश्ता किया जाए कि ना किया जाए, है ना। फाइनल दीदार ऑफ ए डेटा इज ग्राफिक्स, है ना, एंड दिस एस्पेक्ट ऑफ आर इज वेरी पावरफुल। ठीक, समझ बात आई। चलिए, डॉट चार्ट नेम्स देखिए, नाम के साथ इसने सॉर्टिंग कर दिया और प्लॉटिंग कैरेक्टर 15। नाउ ए प्लॉट विद डिफरेंट प्लॉटिंग कैरेक्टर्स, ये देखिए, तो मैं ऑलरेडी मैं कर चुका हूं पहले, मैंने इसको समझा लिया कि क्या है ये, है ना। देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ रनिंग इट अगेन। ये देखिए, मैट्रिक्स ऑपरेशंस एंड डिफरेंशिएशन एंड इंटीग्रेशन विद आर, देखिए, है ना। मैट्रिक्स एक्चुअली इज द बेसिस ऑफ मेनी लैंग्वेजेस, लाइक यू नो मैटलैब, द मेन एलिमेंट इज मैट्रिक्स। सो हाउ टू डिफाइन ए मैट्रिक्स? दिस इज अ मैट्रिक्स विच आर डिफाइनिंग, दिस द फंक्शन इज मैट्रिक्स एंड दीज आर द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द मैट्रिक्स, n कॉल इज इक्वल टू 2, द नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स इज इक्वल टू 2, यू रन इट in the matrix, so this is the output of the matrix, है ना? Get determinant of the matrix, get inverse of the matrix, देखिए, get diagonal elements of a matrix, if x is a diagonal vector, you can create a diagonal matrix by using the same function diag. So we are creating a diagonal matrix whose diagonal elements are 2, 4, and 5, है ना? D2 diag 3, create an identity matrix of order 3. Define a function to get trace of a matrix. Trace of a matrix is what? TR, trace of a matrix. The keyword is function and sum of diagonal elements of X. This is TR. Use this function. One of the powerful features of R is that you can define your own function. The trace of the matrix. Get transpose of a matrix, get cross product of a matrix, get eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a matrix. Eigenvalues and eigenvectors. This is a very difficult task, those who know about, to get program about. Then partial differentiation. I'm not going to cover this. This is the first derivative. Differentiate this function. See, evaluate it at x is equal to 3. We are getting the results. Differentiate it again, second derivative, evaluate it at x equal to 3. So, integration with R, actually, define a new function, fx is equal to 2 into x raised power 2. Find the function. The keyword is function. To define a new function, the keyword is function. And then this is the argument of the function. And we are writing the expression 2 into x raised power 3. Integrate it in the limit of minus 2 to 3. So the function is integrate this result. Dump this. You have created a function. You can save it. The function is dump. Dump in double quotes, file is equal to f1.txt. If you dump it, it will be dumped into your folder. Get area under the normal curve from minus 1.96 to 1.96. Understand? This area is actually 0.95. This is a well-known fact. So we are defining fx is equal to d norm. Integrate it from 1.96 to. So the result is 0.95. Probability distributions in R, actually all these standard distributions you can have, like D norm actually is to get the value of the density, P norm to get the CDF, Q norm to get the quantiles. Those who have a statistics background, they can understand all these things, and those who are dealing with data. Now simulation, R norm, D norm, P norm, and Q. D norm is for value of the density, P norm is for probability of the density, Q norm for quantile inverse of the probability, and R norm is for random simulation. Simulate heights of 500 students of AMU with mean 163 and SD3. So the function is R norm. Height R norm n is equal to 500, mean is 168, SD is 3. We have simulated, you can look into the data. Control 2. हम थोड़ा सा इसको जरा ले जाएं ऊपर. देखिए यहां पर है ना, यू हैव सिमुलेटेड दिस डेटा, अंडरस्टैंड. नाउ इफ यू विल टाइप हाइट, हाउ मेनी ऑब्जर्वेशन, 500 ऑब्जर्वेशन आर बीइंग सिमुलेटेड. बट इफ यू वांट टू सी हाइट से फर्स्ट 5 ऑब्जर्वेशन, 1:5 the first 5 observations, na? Observation from 400 to 405, you can extract them like this. So actually this data is being simulated. From this data you shall not be able, although you know the population, what is the average height of the student, 168, and his SD is 3 plus minus 3. Now how to get mean? Control 1. The function is mean height, 168.02, you know. SD is around 3. Yes. Get the quantile. The minimum is 158.97 and maximum is 179. And the first quartile is 166, median is 167.86, like that. So these are the summary features. So ye tha hamara biodata ka interaction wala part. Final didar kab hoga? Jab hum graphics dekhenge. Look into the graphics of above simulated data. The best graphics for this data is histogram. The function is hist, and this is the data height. Prob is equal to 2 means actually it will give relative frequencies, and limit of y-axis is c0 to 0.15. This is the y limit, and there is no main title. Just I'm running this command hist. They got the histogram. Understand? Now what we are going to, add a curve to plot a curve. The function is curve. Curve d norm, the density of the normal distribution. And whenever we write curve here, we always write x, because it identifies which will go on x-axis. Mean is 168, SD is 3. Add is equal to 2. Actually, there is a concept of high level graphic function and low level graphic function. High level graphic function always create a new plot, and low level graphic function, they add on existing plot. So hist is a high level graphic function because it has generated a new plot, that is bar plot. Curve is also high level, but we want to add a normal curve on this. We are making it low level by using add is equal to true. And LWD stands for line width. It is for line width. LWD is 2. Normal is 1. 2 means twice of the, 2 times thickness of the normal. Understand? So you just control enter. Sorry. Actually, is pure ko hume run karna padega, tab ye aayega. Abhi hum ek ek karke isme yahan run nahi kar payenge. Hai na? Dekhiye, ye kya hamara margin text. Margin text. हम इस पूरे को रन करेंगे तब आएगा. देखिए मार्जिन टेक्स्ट में क्या है, हमें मार्जिन, देयर आर 4 मार्जिन ऑफ ए फिगर है ना, मार्जिन 1, मार्जिन 2, मार्जिन 3 एंड मार्जिन 4. अंडरस्टैंड? एंड एक्चुअली दोज मार्जिन आर साइड आल्सो, साइड 1, साइड 2, साइड 3 एंड साइड 4. एंड हियर लाइन इज इक्वल टू -1 मींस एक्चुअली इट इज द नॉर्मल रेंज इज दिस वन, -1 मींस बिलो दिस. Character expansion is 2 and font type is 4. So virtually we will run the whole chunk and then you will get the graph. देखिए ये आ गया. हमने just यहाँ क्लिक किया, सारे को एक साथ रन कर दिया. तो क्या हो गया ये, है ना? This hist generated the histogram and then we are putting while in c.14 because here it is 0.12. If you put 0.14, then it will be inside the range. Then main title, there was no main title because we wanted to add this curve d norm. Now we have added the curve, add is equal to 2, so that it will add on existing plot. LWD, this thickness is twice of the normal, otherwise you will have thin line. So LWD line width, M text, margin text, that first argument is text, height of students. This is the side is equal to 3. This is the first side, this is the second side, and then side is equal to 3, the third side. Side is equal to 4 is this side. So line is equal to minus 1, actually minus 1. If you write plus 1, then it will be one character above. Minus 1 is one character below. So it is coming here. Then character expansion, it is 2 times this one. And font 4 is for italic font. So all these options are there. So this way you can have the graph. See, go ahead. Plotting functions using curve. I have already told you about the function. We have already dumped function f. What is this? The function is 2 into x raised power 3. We want a curve from minus 2 to 3. And then this is the curve is a high level graphic function. It has plotted the curve y is equal to actually this is 2 into x raised power 3 in the range of minus 2, 2 plus 3. If you want, this is the high level graphic function curve here. F line running, actually adding a line. F stands for AB. Just control two, just I am writing. F line is a low level graphic function. Actually, it is like y is equal to a plus dx, you know. So this is known as F line because of A and B, F line. Here, actually, F line has argument A and B that talks about the intercept and the slope of the line. But here, we are having F line V is equal to 0. Add a vertical line at X is equal to 0. So when you run this, you will have a vertical line at X is equal to 0. Sorry. देखिए फिर ये पूरा एक साथ चंक हम रन करेंगे तभी चलेगा ये कंसोल पर तो चलता है लेकिन यहाँ नहीं देखिए ये आ गया है ना वी हैव एडेड अ लाइन एट एक्स इक्वल टू जीरो सपोज यू वांट ए हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन एट 20 सो व्हाट यू विल डू एब कंट्रोल टू एब लाइन एच नॉट वी इज इक्वल टू 20 यही पर हमें लिखना पड़ेगा सॉरी कंट्रोल वन एब लाइन एच इज इक्वल टू 20 नाउ व्हेन वी विल रन दिस चंक वी विल हैव द होल थिंग देखिए ये आ गया ग्राफ बनकर के आ गया है ना ये ग्राफ बनकर के आया है ग्राफ कहीं छुप रहा है इसमें आ गया देखिए आप है ना देख रहे हैं दिस वन इज बिकॉज ऑफ कर्व वी गॉट दिस कर्व देन वी वांटेड वर्टिकल लाइन एट जीरो सो वी यूज एब लाइन वी इज इक्वल टू जीरो वी गॉट दिस वी वांटेड हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन एट 20 सो वी यूज दिस सो दिस वे वी आर गेटिंग द रिजल्ट वी आर गेटिंग द ग्राफिक्स नाउ प्लॉटिंग नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विद टी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन Again, the curve D norm from minus 3 to plus 3. So, add a T distribution with degree of freedom 30. Add then legend because we are having two curves. Legend is to be used. Legend it is top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right, and center also. And what is in legend? See, normal 01 and T with 30 degrees of freedom. And the line width is, the first line is having line width 1 and second is thicker. BTY is equal to N, there is no box around that. So when we run, we get the result. See, this is the legend because of the thin line. See, because we statistically we say that if your T distribution with 30 degrees of freedom, it is more close to the normal distribution. This is a general result in statistics. So I have made a comment of all these things. You can read that. Now, sampling distribution with R, the function is, this is a statistical concept. I'm not going to discuss that. Understand? Like, because none of you are from statistics. Similarly, fitting a distribution using optim, I'm not going to discuss that. Comparing two groups, t-test, you know, you might be using teaching students t-test. Suppose you have scored up the students x1 and score up the students x2, there are five students, and to test the average score are same in both the group. Our null hypothesis is mu mean of batch A is equal to mean of batch B versus they are not same. The test criteria is t-test. In R, the function is t.test. In R, the function is t.test. Actually, t.test for t-test, chi-sq.test for chi-square test, for Fisher test, the Fisher.test, like that. So this is t.test. The first argument is x1. Here, you know, when we teach t-test to our students, we say that there is basic assumption that is homogeneity of variance. But by default here, they have not made this assumption because that becomes complex. But in R, actually you run this data first. This is the first data of the first batch. This is the data of the second batch. Now we are using t-test, t.test. When variances are not equal, this is an approximate t-test. And the result is this. It is Welch test, and a t value of t is statistically minus 6.7. Degree of freedom is 5.065, p-value 0.00. P-value 0.006 means it is less than 0.05. That means there is significant difference between the two groups. And this is the confidence interval. And this is the mean of the first group, and this is mean of the second group. Understand? The real t-test, which we normally teach to our students, in which we make the assumption that variances are equal, we have to put an additional argument where dot equal is equal to true. Where dot equal is equal to true. Now, this is the result. Here, degree of freedom is 8. 8 because n1 plus n2 minus 2. 5 plus 5 minus 2, that is 8. And p-value is 0.0014. Since p-value is less than 0.05, our difference, our H0 is being rejected. There is significant difference between the means of the two groups. Understand? See, here you can assign the whole result. We have a brief out.
So excuse me. So that where that dot equal, that stands for actually, can you please?
That variances are equal. This is an assumption of t-test. I have written a comment. Variances right. are equal. Variances of the two population are equal. This is an assumption.
Okay.
Then only we can use the t-test, this t-test.
All right. All right. Thank you, sir.
So this is a very important theoretical aspect. सी ये बताइए आप लोगों ने लोग ज्यादातर सौतन से वाकिफ हैं जब सौतन को रन करते हैं तो कितनी सारी चीजें सामने आती हैं है ना दिस इज अ बिग ड्रॉबैक ऑफ एसपीएसएस इज दैट व्हेन यू रन यू गेट मेनी गार्बेज आउटपुट है ना सौतन इतना कुछ दिखा देती हैं कि बड़ा मुश्किल होता है ये पहचानना कि इसमें अच्छा क्या है बुरा क्या है स्मार्ट क्या है और अगली क्या है ना और फिर लोग एनालिसिस करने के बाद में फिर भागते हैं स्टैटिस्टिशियन के पास वैसे तो एसपीएसएस के एक्सपर्ट होते हैं लेकिन जब आउटपुट पाते हैं तो घबरा जाते हैं कहते हैं भाई पता नहीं है ना आर में आपने देखा कि टी डॉट टेस्ट हमने किया तो बहुत ही स्मार्ट आउटपुट बहुत छोटा सा आउटपुट आया है ये ठीक है यू कैन असाइन योर होल आउटपुट टू एन ऑब्जेक्ट एंड दैट इज फिट डॉट टी टू यू हैव डन द एनालिसिस And you have assigned this to the object, है ना? दीदार करने के यहाँ भी हैं रास्ते देखिए आप कुछ नहीं आया यार ठीक है अब इस fit.22 में क्या क्या चीजें हैं यूज करिए फंक्शन names names क्या चीजें हैं value of statistic parameter p value confidence interval estimate null value standard error alternative है ना method and data name suppose you want to select the value of the t statistic use the name fit.t2 and use the dollar dollar is the extraction operator theek hai yahan dekhiye statistic so it will extract the value of the t statistic which is you know minus 6 point something yes you got this you want the alternative hypothesis two sided alternative suppose you want p value, so fit dot fit dot t2 dollar सारे ऑप्शन आ रहे हैं, यू वांट पी वैल्यू, तो आप क्या करेंगे, ये देखिए आप पी डॉट वैल्यू कंट्रोल इंटर, देखिए आप यू कैन एक्सट्रैक्ट पी वैल्यू. समटाइम्स डॉक्टर से आई डू नॉट वांट एनीथिंग, आई वांट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ द स्टैटिस्टिक एंड पी वैल्यू, सिंस पी वैल्यू इज लेस देन 0.05 वी रिजेक्ट एचआर, देयर इज सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस बिटवीन द मींस ऑफ द टू. Is it clear to you all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now I'm coming on.
Yes, sir.
I'm coming on pair t-test. You know, what is the main difference between t-test and pair t-test? Pair t-test, when your data is in the form of pairing. Here in t-test, which we just discussed, it is about the two independent populations. Suppose you measure blood pressure of a person in the morning and then in the evening. So person is same and you want to see the difference between the blood pressures. So in that situation, observations are paired. So you have to go for pair t-test. Understand? So for pair t-test, if scores are from the same student or from the same animal or from the same plant, then certainly you have to use paired is equal to true. देखिए आपने x1 x2 किया, y dot equal to truth हो गया, variances का assumption. अब यहाँ क्या है, paired is equal to true, so it is paired t test, it gives paired t test, result of paired t test. This is the analysis. x1 x2, the value of t statistic, degree of freedom is 4, the p value is 0.004. It is a bogus data, not real data, but this is the procedure of, and this is the interpretation. Now I am coming on using formula argument. See, similarly, sir, yes.
I have yes, one sir. Question.
Yeah.
Sir, in the t-test and pair t-test, can we get the results for different confidence interval? Like here, we get the result for 95% confidence interval. Can we yes, get yes. from 99%? And
yes, others? Yes, 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 yes. Control 2. Control 2. Just I'm going to say, for example, help. T dot test. एक तो हम स्पेस से देख सकते हैं जरा, इसके अलावा हम एक जरा एक है args, args p dot test. मैं यहां नहीं आया, हेल्प लेना पड़ेगा हमें, हेल्प t dot test. ठीक है, t dot test. देखिए, this is the name of the function, t dot test. देखिए, students t test. यहाँ देखिए, बहुत सारी चीजें हैं. It is in the stats package. और यहाँ पर देखिए है, confidence level is equal to 0.95. है ना? क्या है? Confidence level 0.95. इसी तरह से देखिए आप alternative, alternative two sided by default, then less and greater दोनों possible हैं. Mu is equal to zero, you can put mu is equal to some value also. Paired is equal to false, now we have used paired is equal to true. And here confidence level 0.95 by default. Suppose you want confidence level at t dot test. Understand? And here, actually the data is x1 comma x2 and paired is equal to true, and the argument conf dot level, kya argument hai ye? Conf dot level is equal to 0.95. Conf dot level, conf dot level is equal to 0.99. Suppose you want, understand? Not 0.95, 0.99. See, this is the result. This is the result. Understand?
Okay.
Sorry. It is giving 95% confidence interval. Conf dot level. Oh, conf dot level का जो argument है वो सही नहीं लगा. देखिए अब. Conf dot label. Comfort dot label. नहीं जरा देखना पड़ेगा इसमें क्या है conf 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 dot label और हम लोगों ने क्या दिया है कमांड चूंकि यहाँ
सर वहाँ पर conf था वो
ये हो गया ना गड़बड़ हो गया देखिए इस वजह से गड़बड़ हो रही है चलिए conf conf dot label ये आ गया 99% कामिंग इंटरवल सो यू कैन हैव एनी लेवल आ गया 99% कामिंग इंटरवल क्या होगा ये इज इट क्लियर टू यू नाउ
यस सर थैंक यू सर
दिस वे एक्चुअली एंड यू मस्ट रीड अ बुक है ना यू मस्ट रीड अ बुक ये हेल्प है इसका इसमें बहुत सारी चीजें हैं इसके अंदर भी हेल्प है लेकिन फिर भी ये किताब जरूर पढ़िए द बुक ऑफ डेलगार्ड और देयर आर सम मॉडर्न बुक्स आल्सो आई हैव रिटन ए गुवाहाटी टॉक And that is also quite useful. And that is freely. If you write me an email, I will send you the Guwahati talk. That was my talk in 2011 in Guwahati University. And I have provided that in the form of a manual. Okay.
Okay.
So, we have already done about, now using the formula argument, we have already done, using the formula argument, see similarly, if you are interested in comparing these two groups, By using the formula argument, you combine the vector. Actually, normally what happens, your data is like this, that in one column, you have combined both the vectors x1 and x2, and that is the score. See, control 2, type score. See, first 5 observation for x1 and next 5 for x2. Understand? Then, we have the function GL group. GL stands for actually generation of label and factors. So the first argument, how many labels? There are 2 labels, batch A and batch B. And how many observations in each label? 5 observations. And their labels are batch A and batch B. So this we can generate. Control 2, write group. Batch A, batch A, batch A, batch A, then batch B, the labels are batch A and batch B. Understand? So, virtually, this is the factor variable. Normally, what happens that you have your data of score in one column and your data of factors in the other column. Understand? And you want to make the command. So, here we will use formula argument. Formula, when tilde is there, it is formula. That is, score is modeled as a function of group. Score is modeled as a function of group. Score is the numeric vector, this one, and group is the factor vector, that is this one. So you just run this p dot test. Same result we are getting, but we are using formula argument because actually formula argument is more useful. You will learn later. Dekhiye here. अब आ जाइए क्रिएशन ऑफ ए लिस्ट सो फार वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट वर्चुअली काम थे ये देखिए So far we have talked about the data vector, then matrix. Here, you know, there are certain limitations with matrix and data vector. Your all data should be of one type. You cannot combine like here in a list. This is a numeric vector. This is a character string. This is a scalar. Even if you have a matrix, you can combine them all together in an object like a matrix. Here it is list, that is listed data. So this is even you here is a, it is a vector. You can add with argument a matrix also. So this is the flexibility of listed data object. The function is list. And see, first argument of the listed data is a vector. Here it is named character string, and then median is single scalar. We can dump this data, we can save this data into a file to save it, and we can call it by using the function source. Now see, So this is a concept of listed data in R, which is very important. Now t-test with a data frame. A data frame is a two-dimensional tabular form. One can create a data frame by using the function data.frame as C. A data frame is like Excel sheet. You know, in Excel sheet, what is the problem? It is like a matrix, but you know, there are limitations in a matrix that R column must be either character string or R should be numeric. Here in a data frame, some column can be numeric and some of them can be character string, some of them can be, so that suppose you have age of the person, so that will be numeric. Suppose his income, and if you have recorded income into categorical, so that will be a factor variable, low, medium and high. Suppose his gender, that will be male, female, that will be 0101, so that will be logical variable. And say again his real income, so that will be a numeric variable. Here suppose these are the two vectors, score and group. We have already defined score and group. We want to combine them in a data frame. Like just I'm typing here score, 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 sorry, control 2, score, this is a numeric vector, then group, this is a factor vector. You want to combine them in a rectangular format. So the function is data of dot frame, data dot frame, score and group, and we assign them to an object df1. So run this, control enter, control 2, see, this is df1. The data has been structured into a rectangular format. Score is the numeric column and group is the factor column. Understand? So this is data. Data manipulation is very important nowadays in the era of data science. Actually, these functions are very important. How to manipulate your data. From vectors, we have made into a rectangular format. And to save them, we are using the function write.table df1 and file this. So this has been saved into your working directory. Print to print them. Now with this data frame df1, we are going to use t-test. T-test, score versus group. Your data is in the data frame. Again, and then to have the graphics, batch A and batch B. This is the box plot. See which group is having higher scores? Batch B. And batch A is having lower score. Understand? Now see here. Arey bhaiya, zara shor kam karo idhar. Kaun shor kar raha? This is a box plot. You know, this is a kind of minimum and this is maximum. This is the median of the data. And this is the first quartile and this is the third quartile. See which group is having higher median, batch B, and batch A is having lesser median. Then which is symmetric and which is skewed? Just tell me which distribution is skewed, batch A or batch B? Which one is skewed?
So batch B.
Batch B, and it is skewed from left. Understand? And because it is here, not from right. Otherwise, it should have been here. Batch A is symmetric because median is coming almost in the mid. So this way, you can compare the data, and actually, this conveys more than the t-test. This conveys more than the t-test. Understand? I have made the interpretation here. And this box plot clearly shows that there is significant difference between the scores of two groups. The scores of batch B are higher than that of batch A. Moreover, the scores of batch B are more variable compared to the batch A, as it is evident from the length of the box. Okay. Now from the same data, we are going to use t-test also, pair t-test. T-test pair is the same data frame, but we are using the result of t-test. Pair t-test, although in principle we should not do that because our observations may not be paired. but we are just for the purpose of illustration, we are using this. Now see, we are creating data frame in another way. Here, batch A is equal to X1 and batch B is equal to X2. This is stacking. देखिए ये हो गया हमारा बैच ए द रिजल्ट ऑफ बैच ए एंड दिस इज द बैच बी वी कैन स्टैक देम स्टैकिंग यू नो स्टैकिंग इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट है ना स्टैक द डेटा देखिए आप ये हो गया हमारा स्टैकिंग हो गई वैल्यूज एंड आइडेंटिफिकेशन ठीक वी वॉन्ट हियर इंस्टेड ऑफ वैल्यूज वी वॉन्ट स्कोर एंड हियर वी वॉन्ट ग्रुप सो जस्ट यूज द फंक्शन नेम्स एंड change that control enter now again print see here is score and group now save the data into a text file and if you have saved the data you can read that and create the data frame again now graphic features of the data here I have written a few comments there are high level graphic functions which are always create a new plot Examples are plot, hist, bar plot, box plot. Low-level graphic functions which add on existing plot examples are lines, points. We are creating a box plot which can be saved as .pdf or .png file also. देखिए आप हमने क्या किया? ये है हमारा chunk R, fig bar one. ये हमारा इसकी labeling है. df1 we are reading the data from the text file df1.txt and header is equal to true header is equal to true means the first line is the name of the variable header is equal to true. So and see the next command actually if you yes aiye iko ha chai haliyo ha see df1 I am virtually The group actually this that if you go to the this window, see the str structure of the data of df1. See the data frame of 10 observation with two variables. Score is numeric, and group is what it is character batch A batch B, which we want to convert into a factor variable. Understand? So for that. We have to use the function df1 group. We are extracting the group from the data frame df1, and this again df1. We are extracting data the group from the data frame df1, and the factor is will convert this group into a factor vector. This will convert into a factor vector, which is must because factors are treated in a different manner in R. Now to save it in a png file like png then name of the file with the extension .png so control enter now actually there is a concept of device in R device is you know your graphics are coming here on the screen but here your file can be a device like this png file figplot1.png this file can be your device figboxplot1.png now whenever you run it you will get your figure is code into that file so plot score versus group you have got this and then to save as pdf instead of png what we are doing we are writing just pdf and extension is also .pdf so here the name is figplot2 so both the graphs you can have from here see fig you can find those blocks fig box plot fig box plot.png just you can open it dekhiye aap and hame dena padega hum kaise kholna chahte hain to ye khul jayega ye options aa rahe hain aur ye hamara fig box plot 2 this is pdf ye dekhiye एक्चुअली ये सब खुलेंगे लेकिन अब जरा इस वक्त थोड़ी सी मुश्किल हो रही है लेकिन आप जब इसको रन करेंगे तो ये सारे ग्राफ राफ बन करके आ जाते हैं आपके डॉक्यूमेंट में है ना, जरूरत नहीं पड़ती है इनको सेव वो करने की। सेव अगर करना चाहे तो ऐसे आप कर लेंगे। सी नाउ वी शैल टॉक अबाउट एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरिएंस टी टेस्ट। इन टी टेस्ट व्हाट वी डू, वी कंपेयर टू ग्रुप एंड इफ यू वांट टू कंपेयर मोर देन टू ग्रुप्स द टेक्निक इज एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरिएंस। So scores of batch C students are also available. Let us see how this can be added. Dekhiye, X1, group of X1, X2, X3. Now score vector has C, X1, X2 and X3 is also being added. And group, here we have three groups and observe each have five observations and levels are batch A, batch B. Then you can create a vector of group. Then you can create a data frame, DFT, you can save that, print the data frame. See here, you are having batch A, batch B. ये पूरा नहीं दिखा रहा, batch C also, है ना? देखिए, अभी हम जा रहे हैं इधर control two, है ना? At DF2. ठीक है, और टेल ये चेहरे का दीदार हो गया, अब आप पैरों का दीदार कर लीजिए। टेल देखिए बैच सी का डेटाबेस में आ गया, नजर आ गया। सो नाउ वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरिएंस। एक्चुअली इनोवा इज यूज्ड व्हेन वी हैव मोर देन टू ग्रुप्स, है ना? दो ग्रुप के लिए भी यूज कर सकते हैं, सिंगल ग्रुप के लिए भी इनोवा यूज कर सकते हैं। इनोवा इज ए जनरल टेक्निक। सो हियर वी हैव क्रिएटेड द डेटा डीएफ2 एंड देन वी हैव सेव्ड इट, प्रिंट नेम्स। हियर द फंक्शन फॉर एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरिएंस इज एओवी, द फंक्शन इज एओवी एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरिएंस। स्कोर इज द न्यूमेरिक वेक्टर एंड ग्रुप इज द फैक्टर वेक्टर एंड डेटा इज डीएफ2। सो we run this, get the summary of result, summary M2. This is the analysis of variance. Understand? This is the analysis of variance. Group has 3 minus 1, 2 degrees of freedom. Sum of square, mean sum of square, p-value. The last one is p-value. 1.94 into 10 raised power minus 6. This shows what? 1.94 into 10 raised power minus 6. That means what? It is much less than 0.05. So that means what? On our H naught is being rejected. And what is our H naught? On average, the three groups have same mean, but actually same score, but that is being rejected because our analysis of variance shows p value is less than 0.05, and hence there is significant difference between the three groups. है ना? एक और function है ANOVA, उससे भी आप result देख सकते हैं। Model the tables, the fitted object is M2, type is equal to means SC, you know? We can get means of the model the tables. It is a very general purpose function. This AOV function works not only for one-way ANOVA, it works for all the two-way ANOVA, factorial experiments, split plot designs. All these things are covered by the function AOV. So virtually it is a very general purpose function. This one is to model the tables. Actually, we want means at each level, and SC is equal to 2. It reports SCD. SCD. So, control enter. See, this is the result. This is the output. This is the table of means, grand mean. To overall mean is this. The group batch A mean is this. Batch B mean is this. Batch C mean is this. Standard of difference of means is 4.SCD. If you multiply SCD with tabulated value, you will get the critical difference. And virtually for all these kinds of analysis, there is a very powerful package and that is known as AgriColi. हो सकता है कल हम बात करें, जो लोग botany में हैं उनके लिए खास तौर से, क्या package का नाम है? AgriColi. Agricoli. This is a very powerful package for getting analysis of variance done, getting latest graphics. वो सारे एरर बार प्लॉट वगैरह सारी चीजें हैं वहाँ, जितने भी मल्टीपल कंपैरिजन के मेथड्स हैं सब उन्होंने डिस्कस किया. जस्ट यू हैव टू राइट इंस्टॉल दैट पैकेजेस Agricoli एंड पैकेज विल बी इंस्टॉल्ड टुमारो. आई मे टॉक अबाउट दैट. सी हियर यू हैव गॉट द मींस एंड देन टुकी एच एस डी. टुकी एच एस डी, हैव यू हर्ड द नेम टुकी एच एस डी? टुकी इज ऑनेस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट डिफरेंस. Actually, you normally teachers teach Fisher's LSD, which is not good. It inflates the level of alpha. The better alternative is Tukey HSD. Tukey is honest significant difference. So virtually we will make a multiple comparison which is equal to group. This is the factor. So see what we are getting. Tukey's multiple comparison means EM कहते हैं इसको multiple comparison. और भी इसके नाम होते हैं लेकिन ये कि ज़्यादा बेहतर है ये group. Batch B versus batch A, the difference is this. The lower limit is this and the upper limit is this, and p value shows what? This difference is statistically significant. Between batch C and batch A, the difference is this, but the p value shows this difference is not significant. Between batch C and batch B, the difference is statistically significant. Now, how can you make graphics of all these things? Use the function plot. O par, set the margins of the figure. O par, par, mar margin, 4 margin at the bottom, 10 margin in the left, 3 margin on the top of the figure, and 2 margin in the right of characters. So O par. Then get plot. यही वाली कमांड हमने इसके अंदर कर लिया. और लैस इक्वल टू ट्रू, लैस इक्वल टू ट्रू. तो ये देखिए आपको मिल गया ग्राफ. ये देखिए आया, ये है हमारा, है ना. ये देखिए जब आप रन करेंगे तो सारी चीजें आएंगी, यहाँ स्क्रीन पर नहीं आ रही. देखिए आप, दिस इज एक्चुअली जब हम पूरा एक साथ रन करें, अभी देखें. और ये है हमारा ग्राफ. नहीं आ रही हैं चीजें, चलिए, क्योंकि काफी चीजें हमने इसमें जमा कर दी हैं इस ग्राफ में. बार कंट्रोल, ये सब चीजें. अब मैं आता हूं जरा इसको दूसरे तरीके से मैं दिखा रहा हूं. अब है ना, अब हमने ऑलरेडी जनरेट की है ना एक फाइल, इसकी एचटीएमएल फाइल शांति देखिए. हाँ, वी भारती आरएमडी पीडीएफ, और ये है हमारा एचटीएमएल, और एक उसके नीचे है वर्ड. देखिए है ना, दिस डॉक्यूमेंट हैज बीन जनरेटेड बाय, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट हाउ वी कैन जनरेट दिस. वी वर हैविंग एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरिएंस. देखिए ये एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरिएंस है ना. So these are the data sets and these are the results. Go ahead, go page down. This is the whole data, names, then analysis of variance. We have already discussed these things. These are the outputs. Then Tukey HSD, we have already done. Actually, this is the OPAR and this is the plot Tukey less equal to 2. So this graph shows virtually there is a vertical line at zero. There is a vertical line at no difference. Understand? And see here the contrast of, if this line crosses an interval, that contrast is not significant. So since it is crossing, batch C versus batch A, this contrast is not significant, and we have seen that. Whereas the difference between batch B and batch A, it is positive and it is statistically significant also. Similarly, between batch C and batch B, actually the difference is negative and it is statistically significant also. Batch C is having lower score and batch B is having higher score. So this is all just by making single command, and that is plot. That is plot. Par O par, actually just to return to the original settings of the graphic parameters. Now plot score versus group. This is the command, data is equal to df2. When we use this command, we get this box plot. We get this box plot. Understand? See, it is evident from this plot that batch B is having highest score as compared to batch A and batch B. And there does not seem to be the much difference between batch A and batch C. So this is the graphic output. Then there is one more output, and that is plot.design. Plot.design. Ye kya hamara? Just the data frame is df2, we are extracting. After comma means we are extracting columns. Before comma means we are extracting rows. So after comma, in this round, in this square bracket, we are selecting score and group. And it is showing plot.design, it is showing the plot. See, the plot of means, it is plot of means. See, this is the overall mean. Overall mean, this is the overall mean. This is the mean of batch B. This is the mean of batch A. And this is the mean of batch C. What you can interpret, batch B is much above the average. Batch A is average, it is somewhat closer to this, and batch C has the least. So virtually, if you have some other factors too, it will have all for this kind of plot of means for all those batches, all those factors, which we will talk in factorial designs in tomorrow's talk. Now, the regression analysis. Yes. Regression analysis. Think of scores of the group are linearly related or not. Measures of linearity are correlation and regression coefficients. Let us see how to create data frame for this purpose. We have created data and saved it as a text file. This is the data x1, x2, x3. Then we have made data frame names batch A, batch B, and batch C. So this is the data. We have created the data. We have saved it. To get correlation matrix, use the function core as core, Carl Pearson product moment correlation. DF1, the batch A, we are selecting batch B, and this is the correlation. Understand? Suppose you want, instead of Pearson's product moment correlation, some other method, there is the option of comma, and then method is equal to one is Carl Pearson, that is by default, and then Spearman rank correlation, and then Kendall's tau. So all those options are there. Now to test the statistical significance, this is the estimate of the correlation coefficient. Now we are testing is core dot test. Understand? Product moment correlation. The value of t is 0.94, and actually the shows the correlation is not significant because p value is greater than 0.05. Understand? Or 95% convex interval contains zero, so that means it is not significant. And this is estimate. Core, yes. Correlation method is equal to Spearman. If you want Spearman's rank correlation, you just give this additional option and you can get Spearman's, the estimate is minus 0.3. If you want the whole correlation matrix, core DF3, the data frame is having three columns. This is the correlation between batch A and batch A, batch A and batch B, between batch A and batch C. Between batch A and batch C, the correlation is positive. Between batch A and batch B, the correlation is negative. And actually, this above diagonal is same as below diagonal because it is a symmetric matrix. You can round this matrix up to three places of decimal. The function is round. Round core DF1 up to 3. Digit is equal to 3. So we can round it up to 3 places of decimal. So this is the data fit. You know what is the definition of correlation coefficient, by the way? You know what is the definition of correlation coefficient? Boliye beta, aap log. What is the definition of correlation coefficient? What it measures? Hello. Kya maujood hai?
Sir, it measures the linear correlation between the two variables.
I'm trying to define correlation. So how you will define what it measures?
Linear association between the variables.
Isme beta strength of linear. Strength of linear. It measures strength of linearity between the two variables. Understand? It measures the strength of linear relationship between two variables. Just yeah, definitely. Strength of linearity. Hai na? Agar hamara point zero ke aas paas hai, iska matlab weak linear relationship hai. Aur agar point zero se right side mein hai, plus one ki taraf se strong correlation hai. Aur agar left mein hai, to negative correlation hai. Hai na? And that is also strong. So like here, the correlation between batch A and batch B is what? It is negative correlation and it is almost 50%. But here between batch A and batch C, it is positive. Understand? Strong correlation like that. So here we are going to talk about fit a simple linear regression model. Understand? For the same data. You know, simple linear regression, you understand? Y is equal to a plus beta naught plus beta 1 x plus error. Here, actually LM stands for linear model. And virtually, linear model is the structure for fitting all the data in the analysis of variance, in simple regression, in multiple regression, in the analysis of variance, analysis of covariance. So all those things are handled by a function LM. LM stands for linear model. So here batch A is the response and batch B is the input. This is the output and this is the input. Data is equal to DF3. Understand? The function is LM. When you run this, print the result. Okay, print M1. Ye chota didar hai ye. Ye kya hai hamara print M1? Ye chota didar hai. Khali keh raha, what is regression coefficient? What is the intercept and what is the slope? Hai na? Bada didar kiske liye hai? Bada didar ke liye kya function hai? समरी ये छोटा दीदार और ये बड़ा दीदार, इसके बाद एक स्मार्ट दीदार भी है, हम उस पर भी आएंगे. देखिए आप LM बैच ए वर्सेस बैच बी, दीज आर द रेजिडुअल्स ऑफ द मॉडल, एस्टीमेट्स ऑफ द रेजिडुअल्स एंड दीज आर द इंटरसेप्ट एस्टीमेट ऑफ, दिस इज द एस्टीमेट ऑफ द इंटरसेप्ट एंड दिस इज द एस्टीमेट ऑफ द रिग्रेशन कोएफिशिएंट. हाउ यू विल इंटरप्रेट दिस रिग्रेशन कोएफिशिएंट -0.287? यू नो what is the definition of a regression coefficient? How you define this? How you define regression coefficient? Boliye beta, boliye. Correlation measures strength of linear relationship between two variables. But what regression coefficient measures?
Sir, how the independent variables affected the dependent variables?
Virtually, it is, you just remember this definition, you should write. Regression coefficient is the change in the response variable, change in the response variable for unit change in the input variable. Your input is labor, output is production. So if you change the labor input by one unit, ek labor aapne badha diya, तो प्रोडक्शन पर जो है कितना फर्क पड़ेगा, दैट इज नोन एज रिग्रेशन कोएफिशिएंट. सो चेंज इन द रिस्पांस वेरिएबल फॉर यूनिट चेंज इन द रिग्रेशन. अंडरस्टैंड? सो हियर दिस इज द एस्टीमेट ऑफ द इंटरसेप्ट, दिस इज द इंटरसेप्ट ऑफ द स्लोप. हियर क्या हो रहा है, ये डिक्रीज हो रहा है. स्टैंडर्ड एरर, यू डिवाइड दिस बाय दिस, यू विल गेट टी वैल्यू एंड दिस इज द पी वैल्यू. है ना? बिकॉज डेटा इज बोगस, सो दैट्स व्हाई डोंट बदर अबाउट द results of signal. We just try to understand what is the interpretation. What is the residual standardized estimate of the sigma? What is R square? 0.228. How you will interpret this 0.228? Can you interpret this? What is R square? How you define R square? Boliye.
Sir, among the total variation of Y, how the variation due to the independent variable? That is the ESS by TSS, that is R square.
Actually, beta, R square is nothing but it measures the proportion of variability explained by the model. है ना जो बात आपने कही उसी को हमने कहा लेकिन थोड़ा सिंपल जबान में है ना R square measures the proportion of variability explained by the model. So how much proportion is being explained by the model? 23%. क्योंकि हमारे पास डेटा बहुत कम है तो इस वजह से ये इंटरप्रेशन कुछ ठीक नहीं है मतलब रिजल्ट ठीक नहीं लेकिन है ये मेथड यही है ना ये क्या हुआ 23% of the variability is explained by the model. अब आइए एक मैं स्मार्ट दीदार की बात कर रहा था ना देख रहे हैं स्मार्ट दीदार की मैंने बात की ना एक्चुअली देयर इज ए पैकेज ARM एक्चुअली दिस इज देयर इज ए ग्रेट बुक ऑन मॉडलिंग एंड दैट इज ए बुक बाय गिलमैन एंड हिल क्या ऑथर्स हैं उसके गिलमैन एंड हिल 2006 The title of the book is Data Analysis Using Regression and Hierarchical / Multi-Level Models and virtually the book is published by Oxford University Press. That is a great book. ARM. The implementation of that book is ARM, analysis using regression and multi-level like that. Actually, that is a great book, and its package is ARM. So that was in the base. Now they have developed another package that is known as RStandARM. ये package ARM है, अब जो उन्होंने नया develop किया वो क्या है? RStandARM, एक stand language आई है. जो बेजियन डेटा एनालिसिस की लैंग्वेज है जो बड़ी जबरदस्त है हम कल दिखाएंगे कि कैसे आपको रिजल्ट्स और कैसे बड़े धांसू ग्राफिक्स आते हैं उसमें है ना सो वर्चुअली दे हैव डेवलप्ड ए फंक्शन डिस्प्ले यू हैव टू इंस्टॉल दिस पैकेज इंस्टॉल दैट पैकेज इज ARM एंड देन यू यूज लाइब्रेरी ARM एंड डिस्प्ले M1 डिटेल इज इक्वल टू ट्रू सो दिस क्लीन आउटपुट यू विल हैव virtually. So virtually, this is a smart didar of the same result. देखिए यहाँ पर यहाँ देख रहे हैं कितना सब कुछ गंदगी है दुनिया भर की चीजें हैं इसमें लेकिन इसका स्मार्ट दीदार इन्होंने करा दिया एंड दैट इज बाई द फंक्शन डिस्प्ले सो ARM इस वक्त बहुत ही पावरफुल है इकोनॉमेटिशियंस बायोलॉजिस्ट सब लोग इसको यूज करना हो सकता है कल अगर मौका लगा तो मैं उसके बारे में बात करूंगा RStandARM That is a very powerful package of R. So, look into the graphics. Look into the plot, batch A versus batch B. Wahi function hai, lekin dono numeric hai, to kya ho jayega? Isme scatter diagram ban jayega. Plot, it is because of this command, plot batch A versus batch B. Batch A is on y-axis and batch B on x-axis and data is going to df3. And we have added F line M1. So actually M1 is the object which is fitted as simple linear regression model. It extracts the intercept and the slope of the line from there and adds the line. यहाँ ये देखिए मैं एक बार अगर जाऊँ वहाँ दिखाता हूँ आपको देखिए हम कहाँ थे ये है ना हाँ देखिए हमने यहां पर दिखाया था आपको DF3 देखिए हमने लाइन फिट कर दिया इन द समरी ऑफ रिजल्ट्स, ठीक है. हियर आई हैव पुट ए कमेंट अगेंस्ट इंस्टॉल डॉट पैकेजेस बिकॉज वी नीड नॉट टू इंस्टॉल, आई हैव ऑलरेडी इंस्टॉल्ड इन माय ओन सिस्टम. यू विल remove this for installation into your own system and then use install dot packages arm, it will install, then only you can use library arm and then display the result. Look into the graphics, ye dekhiye graph aa gaya, isse kya hua hamara scatter plot na aur f line se lines mein add ho gayi. Sorry, dekhiye yahan yahi pareshani aa rahi hai ki jab hum R studio mein karte hain to ye thoda sa zara ये सब चीजें साथ लेके चलता है. देखिए ये आ गया, ये देखा आपने, पहले खाली स्कैटर प्लॉट बना उसके बाद ये लाइन ऐड हो गई. नाउ आई विल कम ऑन, देखिए हम कहां थे, वी भारती पर ना एचटीएमएल आउटपुट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, वी भारती एचटीएमएल आउटपुट. हाँ देखिए इसका पीडीएफ भी है हमारे पास, बस वही कमांड है, एक ही कमांड है जिसे हम जनरेट कर लेते हैं, ठीक है. सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, यस वी हैव गॉट द, नाउ फिटिंग ए पॉलीनोमियल रिग्रेशन मॉडल. सी द मॉडल इज एक्चुअली फ्रॉम द प्लॉट इट इज एविडेंट दैट यू नो दिस शोज दैट इट शुड बी लाइक दिस, सो इट इज नॉट लीनियर, इट इज कर्वी लीनियर. So that's why we have fitting a polynomial regression model, and that is again the function lm, it is y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x plus beta 2 x square plus error. So m11 is equal to lm batch a versus batch b plus insulator capital I. So what it will do, it will make square of the batch b and then it will add to the model, and data is equal to df3. So the summary of the results, these are the intercept batch B and batch B square, and this is the R square. यहाँ पर देखें आप, वहाँ खाली 22% था, यहाँ पर कितना हो गया? Here 88%, 89% variability is explained by the model. So this model is better. Now we can have the graph plot batch B versus batch A while in 030 data is equal to df3. We are using to plot this curve, we are using this function curve coef m1 first plus this is the intercept plus coef m11 2 second into x plus coef m11 3 third coefficient into x to the power 2, and this will add this plot. Dekhiya. So it is better. Now fit a multiple linear regression model. Actually, this curvy linear is not multiple because we are using only one predictor. But here in multiple regression analysis, we are using two predictors, batch B and batch C. When we use more than one predictor, the analysis is known as multiple regression analysis. So here, batch LM versus batch B plus batch C and data is equal to DF3. So here we are adding the batch C also, and we are getting the result, the multiple regression analysis done. This is the intercept, regression coefficient first, regression coefficient corresponding C, and these are the p values, and see 0.484% variability is explained by the model. Now model comparison. ANOVA M1 and M2. M1 is what? The model M1 is what? It is simple linear regression model. And M2 is the multiple linear regression model. Batch B was the predictor in case of M1, but batch this M2 contains both the information about batch B as well as batch C. So addition of batch C virtually, that is whether simple linear regression model is being improved by multiple linear regression model or not. So the function is ANOVA M1. See, the model one is batch B versus batch A versus batch B, and model two is batch A versus batch B plus batch C. So what you get? you get virtually, sorry, देखिए M2 हमारा मल्टीपल लीनियर रिग्रेशन मॉडल है और इसके रिजल्ट्स ये हैं. नाउ वी आर कंपेयरिंग दीज टू मॉडल्स बाय मेकिंग यूज ऑफ इनोवा. व्हाट इट शोज, इनोवा M1 इन M2, इनोवा AOV फॉर एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरिएंस, इनोवा इज फॉर मॉडल कंपैरिजन. सी व्हाट दिस पी वैल्यू शोज, 0.4238. दैट मींस एडिशन ऑफ scores on batch C multiple linear regression is not benefiting, and actually addition of this batch C is not benefiting the model, is not benefiting the model. So this is known as model comparison. I think I should stop at here kyunki abhi to kafi cheeze hain karne ki aur hum aap logon ke sath thoda interaction karna chahte hain. आ रहे हैं इस पे. हाँ वेल, हाँ जी सिद्धप्त घोष, ये सभी लोग ऑन कर रखे हैं. डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन टू आस्क रिगार्डिंग माय प्रेजेंटेशन, एनी क्लैरिफिकेशन, एनीथिंग? हम ये शेयर कराएंगे आप लोगों को पीडीएफ फाइल. डू यू हैव एनीथिंग टू क्लैरिफाई, क्योंकि अब एक बजने वाला है, 12:55 है, हम अपनी टॉक अब खत्म कर रहे हैं, हम कल फिर मिलेंगे. डू हैव एनी? यस यस, समवन इज ट्राइंग टू स्पीक, बोलिए बेटा इफ यू हैव समथिंग टू इंटरेक्ट विद मी. इससे पहले भी हमारा, मैं पिछले साल गया था वहां शांति निकेतन में, उससे पहले एक बिहारा कॉलेज है, वहां मैंने एक वर्कशॉप की थी यार पे, और इसके अलावा आईएसआई भी हम गए हैं एक दो बार.